we were in the battle, we had to win, because we never did know what was going on until all them shells and all that stuff was popping, and the sky was black, shells and everything going everywhere. We didn't know what was, we didn't know what we were going into, so we had to win.
And what did they look like?
What?
The mask.
The mask, like the little helmet thing, and I mean they fit on your head just like a glove, boy. You couldn't hardly get them off. It was made out of rubber. It wasn't steel, it was made out of rubber. Once you got them on your head, you couldn't hardly get them off. They fit so tight. Because you had a tube in there, you had to put it in your mouth to breathe by if you didn't even go to the day.
You wore those when you got off the each battle. You said,
when we was getting off the ship, they just put a battle way out in the ocean. We had to get off of that ship on them old flat barges, go up to throw shore out.
Yeah, we'd have to actually wear those.
Yeah, because you never didn't know what was going on until you got them, got everything cleared away, and things wasn't, you know. Yes, sir. They mowed us on one run, and our truck and the gun on another. Here we go. We hit that shore, get that truck and that gun out, get it set up, and here we go. Oh. Ooh, Lord.
Have the pets in there like sardines, huh?
Yeah. At least. Well, it take them all day to unload a ship. That's how many they had on all them big guns.
Well, I remember
all them tanks. All that stuff, hundreds of them big ships in a convoy. And they had a spot on shore where we had land at. Everybody had to land right there. Go. And when you in big old tanks and stuff and they're big, that's bad. When they hit the ground, they just kept going.
Yeah.
Kept going. They shot at everything they see. They moved too, but they didn't stay around.
No.
When they pulled in the invasions off them, planes dropping bombs, breaking you and everything else. Oh, my goodness. I never made it, boy. This Lord was so angry on me. Taking on him old damn mind, blowing up.
Time and time again.
Oh, dear, honey. The trees around there, when they made them invasions, wasn't nothing but stumps. Didn't even have a limb or nothing left on them. I mean,
Is that from the bomb?
Yeah, and all them shells, boy. All them shells and things. Yes, sir. Once you start them running, they left all the old equipment and stuff behind. They didn't take it with them. Old trucks, old guns, all that kind of mess. They left it behind. They didn't take it with them. And they made an invasion. You were making early in the morning. Whenever you hit shore, you might drive you might go 40 or 50 miles a day before you don't pull the solid in front of you. You didn't have fun.
Use those gas masks when you were in training, right?
Yeah.
But it was a different kind.
Different kind, yes, ma'am.
So different kind than when you were in the invasion.
Yes, ma'am, it was.
Yeah.
Well, that's a. When we was in training, that was a tear gauge.
The full mask.
Yeah. When we was in battle, that was poison gas. Every time. I mean, you got a fifth of it, you don't.
The ones you wore in battle were leather, you said?
Huh? Yeah.
They were leather?
Yeah.
Fit real tight over your
yes,
head.
Sir,
you had a tube to breathe out of.
Right. I don't know that thing was fixing that camera some way so you could. Well, if the people ain't in you, I wouldn't be.
What year was that? 1943. You served in the Army from 1943 to when? 45. Five different campaigns in 27 months. You did some traveling, didn't you, Papa?
One in Egypt, one in France, one in Belgium, one in Germany, the other one in North Africa. That's where we did them. We didn't find much in Italy, Italy. I mean, Sicily is just a little island between Africa and Italy.
Yeah.
You had to go across it, you had to cross it. There's a land, water all around it. We went across it. Boom, 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 boom.
Did you ever go to Tuscany in France?
Huh?
Or over there? Did you ever go to Tuscany?
Tuscany.
Tuscany. Like where the vineyards and everything in France.
Oh, no.
Countryside. You never got to see that part of it, did you?
Yes, I did.
Did you?
Oh, I mean, that's all I seen was great. Oh, dear. We had to march through them things, going to fight them.
In the grapes.
Yeah, Lord God, yeah. Just all, every way you could see. Great things, great things. Them old purple boots looking great. Oh, yeah. Olive. Ooh. Had them big old olive groves over there. Just acres of them everywhere.
Y'all fighting the grapes and the olives.
Yeah.
Orchards.
Yes, sir. We had to set up one time. We're pretty close to the airport. We set up like in the middle of a olive grove one time. Yeah. They climbed them over there. Climbed them so close together, you couldn't even see through them. See the sky through them. They set us up in that tent one time. Oh, God, yeah, honey, we went through it. We went through a break one time, I think. Miles and miles, that's all it was. Just rolling. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord, yeah.
I guess when y'all were in that particular time of your life, there wasn't no such thing as getting to stop and sample the food, was it?
No. Didn't think about stopping for no food. We was in that, Pompeii, you ever hear about Pompeii?
Yeah, I've heard of Pompeii.
Well, I was in Pompeii. All them people, all them dogs and cats, every kind of animal, pure stone. That's when
the volcano?
The volcano.
Come down?
Come down. Maybe some of them.
So you went through that, and you actually saw it?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my goodness. Biblical time.
Yes, sir. I sure did. Strange, folks. I tell you, strange. That's a human body sitting there. Pure stone. There's children, babies. Everywhere. Standing in the door. Some laying down. Some half laying down. It was like sweet, buddy. I'll tell you right now. Dog, cat, and every kind of animal was there.
What did your buddies think about all that when y'all went through that? That's amazing.
Well,
I've never heard that story.
Well, I guess they felt like I did this. It's funny, I reckon, I don't know. That volcano when that stuff shooting out of it, running down inside the fields and stuff. So hot. Ashes and stuff. Yeah. I'll tell you, big town, too. You hear everything in it was solid stone.
It's just really amazing, isn't it? Because usually everything's just disintegrated to ashes.
I know it, but this is, it was strange. I mean, you never seen nothing like that. It took you all day to go over the whole thing, see the whole thing, and trying to hide or trying to do something. Some of them trying to get in windows, doors, you know, buildings. The buildings were probably stone too. You never seen nothing like that. You see? Yeah. Oh, God.
Thank you. was a famous trumpet man from all Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand, because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. A toot, a toot, a toot de la da toot. He blows it eight to the bar. In boogie rhythm, he can't blow a note unless the bass and guitar is playing with him. He makes a company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. He was a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie-woogie bugle, he was busy as a buzz bee. And when he plays, he makes the company jump A to the bar. He's a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. Do-do-do-do-da-da, do-do-da-da, do-do-do-do. He blows it A to the bar. He can't blow a note if the bass and guitar isn't with him. And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. Every night, and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet, because they know how he plays when someone gives him a beat. He really breaks it up when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. He plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.